G'day, ladies, and welcome to Step Up. Today, we're going to talk about something that's very serious to you and to me in this season, walking in your true purpose. I have a special guest in the studio with me today. Don't go away. You know you've got to call your girlfriend. You know you've got to get the cake, and we're just going to have a good time tonight. Step Up, ladies. Tonight I have a very special guest in the studio with me, as I said earlier, and her name is Bianca. Bianca is one of this amazing woman behind the Lady Rose Gift of God magazine. So welcome, Bianca.
Thank you, Chantel.
It's awesome to have you ladies here.
Thank you for having us.
Well, when I was in Johannesburg, you guys blessed me, so I'm just so blessed to have you guys here.
Thank you. Now, we are also blessed to be here.
A couple of weeks ago, I was ministering on, the Holy Spirit gave me a word on your call, your purpose, your destiny and your legacy, all of that, how that impacts other people's lives. And I know the ladies know Linda now, who's been on Step Up quite frequently. You are one of the torchbearers of the Lady Rose magazine, which is in fact this magazine.
Yes.
How did your purpose come in alignment with this amazing, great, great magazine?
Well, when I grew up, I always knew there's more to life. I grew up, I had a lot of rejection in my life. I had a lot of hurt. And I was always striving, you know, just to get closer to God and just to get everything sorted. I was always going on courses just to, you know, to get rid of the bondage, get rid of the baggage. And then a few years ago, I met Linda. So, and Linda, she's the one that pushed me over the edge. So she actually pushed me. She said, listen, you have to step out. You have to do what God has called you to do. And so what happened, she asked me if I wanted to be part of Lady Rose. And I thought, yeah, this can't be that bad. You know,
I've got nothing to lose at this point.
Yeah, I can just sit there at the back and I will just support when it's needed. And I will just do what I need. You know, I can pray and I can do stuff. And that is what happened.
Just like that?
Yeah, just like that. We actually became friends. So first we became friends, and after we became friends, we just walked the road. She invited me to some ministry meetings, and I joined the ministry meetings, and I just grew at an exponential speed. And then she said to me, listen, God said it's time to start the magazine. Will I help her? I said, okay, well, yes, let's go. But if I knew then what I knew today, I thought maybe I would have not have done it.
Bianca, tell me, we're talking about purpose today, and this is very relevant because everybody on the face of the earth are born with a purpose.
Yes.
God would not have allowed us to be here if there wasn't a specific role in this life and in this time. Mm. Maybe some short, maybe some longer than the others, but there's a specific role in this generation that you and I need to play, and that's what we need to understand, ladies, gentlemen, wherever we are. Mm. Your role, when we spoke about the yes many, many months ago with me and Linda on Step Up. Your yes, how your yes influences someone else's life, and how that person's life comes into destiny because of your life now.
Yes.
How did you feel when you stepped into Lady Rose and then realize, oh my word, this is actually what I'm supposed to do?
Yeah. It felt like this is what I was born for. This is where I'm supposed to be. This is what I do. Like Linda, she's the front of Lady Rose. She's the face of Lady Rose. But I'm in the back. I'm supporting him. I'm keeping her hands up. She's the one that goes with the vision. God gives her the vision. And sometimes I need to help her to execute the vision. So she needs someone next to her to also help and to guide her, to keep her hands up. Just like in the Bible where Moses had Aaron to keep up his hands. That is what I'm doing. I need to keep her hands high so she can carry this vision forward. So some people will think, okay, but you're just in the back. No, I don't mind being in the back because she needs me to help her to get this forward, and that's fine.
You see, you said something very relevant now, and I want to say this to the ladies. Being a vision carrier, being part of a big vision, something that God birthed on the face of the earth that everybody will know and see. It does not mean that you are part of Lady Rose. You should be on the cover of every magazine, or you should be on the front line. We get those silent people at the back, but when they move, things move in the spirit, and you are one of that. How did that impact you as a person?
Chantal, it gave me fulfillment. It gave me a fulfillment to know that I can actually help to establish something that God has given. It's a purpose. It's a mandate. It's a mandate to take over something for God. So it just gave me a purpose. It gave me a fulfillment. I can't explain it. It's just like, you know, I said to Linda the other day, I feel so sorry for people that just goes to work every day. They come back. No fulfillment, no purpose. This is, if I look at this magazine, it's a fulfillment. You know, people's lives are being changed. People are being touched. Ladies can read this book and they can encounter him. Because at the end of the day, it's all about him. It's not about us. And that is the fulfillment, to get a testimony of someone that said, listen, I picked up the magazine and it just gave me new hope. It's all worth it.
How do you feel when you guys have worked through months of preparing the magazine and then you finally hold the magazine in your hand? How do you feel? Since you are a big part of the Lady Rose magazine.
I always feel excited. It's always like, when one comes out, it's like, is this our next favorite one? No, we don't know. Then the other one comes out, no, this is our favorite one. Every magazine is our favorite one.
It's, for me, it's always, it's unique to know, it's special to know that each and every one of our personalities fits into this massive, big plan.
Yeah.
Your personality, where you come from, how did God work in you for where you are now?
How did you work in me? Well, I'm a very black and white person, and I'm a very structured person. And sometimes visionaries need person with structure. So Linda's the visionary and I'm the structure one. So I'll say, listen, she'll say, we need to do this. And I'll say, okay, but we first need to get this process in place and get this process in place. So I'm the one of all the processes, all the structure and stuff like that. So that's where I fit in.
And personally, how did that change your view in life? Because remember, before we come into purpose, you don't feel worthy. That's one thing that you need to understand. We don't feel worthy of this call. And that's the reason why many times God can never ever, well, not never ever, but sometimes God cannot reveal unto you the complete plan or the end result of the plan. He shows you glimpses of it.
Yes.
You know, sometimes God just reveals certain things to people, you know, far into the vision. But then there's other times where God said, no, I cannot trust you with all of this information because you don't trust me enough. So I've got to give you little bits and pieces to walk into this journey. Yeah. So for you, how was the journey for you?
For me, if I still kept all the rejection I had, because I came out of a lot of rejection, I mean, really a lot, I don't want to go into all that detail. If I kept that, God would not have been able to use me here, because then I would have felt unworthy, I would have felt I'm not important, whatever. But that's why it's very important to know who you are in Christ and to know what He has in store for you, what is His plan for you. Otherwise, you won't be able to fulfill your destiny and your calling. Otherwise, you won't be able to be part of the bigger picture, because everybody's got a specific calling, a specific destiny. And if I didn't step into my place in Lady Rose, it would have been difficult for Linda as well.
There's things that we deal with.
Yes.
There's, when we leave all of this, I have a life that I go to. Yes. I have certain fears maybe that I have to face. There's maybe certain things that I need to deal with in my life. It doesn't mean that we are doing this, what we are doing, and it makes us perfect.
No.
Never.
No.
It just makes us the people that God, it just, how can I say this? It makes the ordinary extraordinary.
Yes.
And this is one thing that I've learned in my life as well, Bianca, that even in your brokenness, God can take the brokenness and He walk you through it.
Yes.
But here's the thing, and now I want you to hear me when I say this. Don't sit still, don't lay, don't stagnate because of the brokenness.
Yes.
Because it's in moving forward.
Yes.
In the purpose that God heals the brokenness. Am I right?
Amen. You're 100% right, Chantal. If I went through a certain situation, say for instance, even in Lady Rose, when we just started and stuff would happen and it will trigger me or something will happen, I will take offense, anything, doesn't matter. I will have to go to God and I'll ask God, listen, what's happening here? Or me and Linda will speak and then we have to sort it out and say, listen, I pick up this, then we have to deal with it. Then I can decide, I can make a decision, I can choose, because the word says choose life or death. I can make a decision, listen, am I going to take this or am I going to, you know, let it go? Am I going to deal with this issue or am I going to let it go? So then you need to sort out whatever the root is of whatever is still going on in your life, and you need to let it go so you can go grow from holiness to holiness and become more Christ-like.
And in this journey, in this process, have you met a lot of women that you need to counsel on their way? Because this is a ministry platform. Yeah. So you know what? And here's the thing with the ministry platform. Mm. We don't all come to the ministry platform whole.
No, we don't. No, we don't come to the ministry. When we will go and minister to ladies, there's a lot of broken ladies there. Some of them will not always come for counsel, but when we are at the events, we normally do pray for them. So there is a lot of broken people out there. And my heart and Linda's heart also is for emotionally broken ladies, because we want to see each lady walk in their destiny, because God has got a plan for each lady, not just for you or for me. There's a plan and a purpose for each lady. And if we don't step into our plan and our purpose, how can we reach the full potential? How can we do what God has called us to do?
People that know you, the Bianca that they see now, say 10 years ago, I almost want to ask you the difference in that. Why I'm asking that is because purpose makes you whole.
Yes.
Purpose. Sometimes we go into purpose, and I don't know why I'm saying this, but sometimes God brings you to that place at the door of purpose, and then you're not whole, but in the process, He heals you. So how is this Bianca in conjunction with the lady that started with the magazine?
This one is...
more bold.
More bold.
I can tell.
More secure. She knows who she is in Christ. She knows what is her purpose. She knows what she needs to do. And she will go and do it because that's what God told her to do.
I like that. This is important. If we don't get that mind shift, that renewing of the mind, we will never be in the place. Because you know what? God wants to birth this thing through you. He wants to use you to be a part of, well, I'm just saying birthing, but, you know, Linda birthed the magazine. Yes. But you are one of the people, I almost want to say, that was in the labor ward catching this baby. So you are a part of this beautiful baby being, you know, being raised. And that is the beauty of carrier, what is torch bearers in the spirit. Yes. We will be right back. Lord Jesus, thank you for creating me in your image. Thank you that in you I lack absolutely nothing. Thank you that according to your word, I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. Thank you for choosing me for such a time as this, so that your glory and presence can be manifested in and through my life right now. Thank you, Holy Spirit, that I know I am never alone, because you live in me, and because of who you are, King Jesus, I will never walk in defeat. I've been set free from all lies of the enemy, and I will not die before my time, but I will live to declare the glory of the Lord in this lifetime and in this land. Today I choose life because I choose truth. Jesus Christ is my truth. As a daughter of destiny, I will step up and step out in faith into the great plan God has for me. I have the DNA of my Heavenly Father. That is why everywhere I go, godly change is made through the power of the Holy Spirit and the living Word of God, which is on the inside of me. This gospel of Jesus Christ will be ministered through me as long as I have breath. It was for this purpose I was born. I declare my life is purposeful. My dreams are God's desire for my life, and my hope is charged with faith. As a daughter of promise, I will run my race with endurance. I will cry on my knees. I will battle through in prayer, and I will rise up in victory on my feet. Because Jesus Christ is the lifter of my head. Amen. Ladies, welcome back to Step Up, and we're talking today about the importance of walking in your true calling and in your purpose. And with me, I've got a special guest, as I said earlier, Bianca, all the way from Johannesburg, Gauteng, as we say.
Yes.
We're talking about purpose and what it means to you. And the reason why we are breaking it down, it's simply so that other women can see. Ladies, if you feel Chantal, forget it. I cannot do it. We want to give you living proof that we once said no. And then when we really had an encounter with the Holy Spirit, we walked out saying yes.
Amen.
So I want to ask you, Bianca, because we're going a little bit deeper now. Being naked in front of God, how does that make you feel? Because before you answer, let me actually explain why I'm saying this. When Ruth and Naomi, when Naomi was training Ruth and getting her prepared for Boaz, for her destiny, there was three things that happened. Number one, she said to her, I want you, Naomi, to bathe yourself. I want you to dress yourself and I want you to anoint yourself. Three things, because what Naomi was telling her was, I want you to get away. I want you to get rid of your past.
Yes.
So I need you to get naked in the presence of God so that God can quickly deal with your past.
Yeah.
Because you cannot move into where you're supposed to go with your past on you. Getting naked in all of this rejection, how did it make you feel?
You know what? For me, it was a thing of, I'm serious with God. So for me, I wanted to get rid of the baggage. I mean, Chantal, if I have to be quite honest, I mean, I was molested as a child by different people. When I grew up at the age of 16, I discovered that my real dad is not my real dad. So I've actually been adopted. Then I discovered that my real dad didn't even want me. So I really came out of a lot of rejection. Then what happened is, because you've got this rejection in you, then you think, if you know, a boy looks at you, then you think it's love. You will accept that love. And it's not true. You know, boys at that age, you know, sometimes
doesn't know a thing about love.
They don't know a thing about love. So I had to deal with all of that rejection. And getting married, I had to deal with it and make sure I don't put it on my husband. Because what happened then when I got married, I expected my husband to fill that for me. And he can't. Only God could take me through the process, heal my emotions, heal the bitterness, heal the anger, heal everything.
Sure.
Yes. But that was a choice. I had to choose.
That's the key word in this whole thing. It was a choice that you made.
Yes. And sometimes if you go through rejection, you will look at the world, like Linda always say, through the glasses of rejection. Someone will say something and then you'll think, oh, they're ugly, they're rejecting me. But it's not. It's because you've got that filters of rejection on you. And then you look at life as rejection.
Bianca, I want to ask you a question. What if I don't know I'm struggling with rejection? What are the signs that shows someone else that person is struggling with rejection?
You feel unloved. You feel unworthy. You feel incompetent. You feel insecure. I mean, sometimes, say for instance, women. We walk into a place and we look at the other women there. We think, oh, she looks nice. She looks pretty. Oh.
And immediately you look down at your own shoes, or you look down at what you are wearing.
That is a sign that you're not happy with yourself. You're still insecure. You're rejected.
Okay, well.
Yeah.
If ever you feel like that, and you know what, because we as women do that, and the reason why I'm asking it, because why, those are signs, and hear me when I say this, the reason why I'm asking that question is because many of us suffers with a spirit that we don't know about.
Yes.
We don't know it's actually an unfamiliar spirit which is in my territory and is attaching himself to me or it's coming from my past.
Yeah.
But I don't know what it is, so I don't know how to pray.
Yeah.
So whenever we see these signs, you know, maybe you come out of a good, you know, family, but your boyfriends broke up with you one after the other, and you come to the place of marriage and you're waiting for this person to reject you as well. So you have this thing all over you and it needs to be broken.
Yes.
What would you say to women dealing with rejection today, especially single women? Because remember, we are trying to get women to a place where they understand they need to be purpose-minded.
Yeah.
You need to be mindful of the fact that God called them, positioned them, getting them ready for their destiny, which is relevant in the 21st century.
I will tell them to go and sit at God's feet and to declare scripture. I mean, in the beginning, I declared scripture on myself. I'm a royal priesthood. I'm chosen. I'm blessed. I'm highly favored. I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. You have to renew your mind and you have to go and sit at God's feet. And He will show you. Sometimes He'll give you dreams. Sometimes He'll give you visions. He will show you. Like lots of times in my life, He will give me dreams and to say, listen, this is not right. You have to sort this out. Or because He loves us so much. He just loves us so much.
Mm. And you, the thing, and how does your husband and yourself in this new life of you, how is that? Because that it's just, it could just bring fulfillment, can it not?
Yes. Now my husband, he's wonderful. He supports me. He supports me in this, and he just says, go for it. And just, he just wants me to do what God wants me to do. So he really supports me in this.
Bianca, did you ever think that you will be in this place in your life ever?
No, not at all. Looking at my childhood, looking at the way I was raised, looking at everything, not in my wildest dreams, no.
Why I'm asking that is because people sometimes think that we, or even myself,
yeah.
When you're young and you're immature in the spirit and you don't know anything, you think that that person just grew up wealthy and they've made it. They are the big names of the world.
No.
And you just think that everybody just... But success is not birthed just out of a silver spoon in my mouth. Success is birthed out of very hard work.
Yeah.
And even the multimillionaires of the world, there's always a struggle. Life will always... Because even if I have the money, then I'll have to fight for something else.
Yes.
So there's always a struggle in life. But it's... I said it earlier today that the Bible says in Isaiah, I think it's 66, the prophet said, will I ever bring you to labor and not bring you and not allow you to birth? God will always allow us to birth destiny.
Yes.
If he brought us to the labor ward.
Yes.
And for you, you're a part of a mighty move of God, not just in the nation, but also internationally. How does that make you feel?
Makes me feel privileged. I feel overwhelmed and I think, God, you use me. I'm just a normal person. And I'm just, I'm very privileged.
Sometimes we really think that it's the big ones. It's those ones. It's this ones, the one with the longer hair, the one with the slimmer. But it's never about that. God looks at our hearts.
Yes.
And what is in our hearts will determine where we are going
yes.
through. Your relationship with the people that you work with, how is that? Because that's part of the destiny.
Yeah.
Everything in your destiny, the people, the place, the leader that you walk with, all of that plays a role in your destiny.
Yes.
How is everybody around you? How is that fulfilling you as a person?
Well, we all work together as a team. So we encourage each other, we support each other, we help each other. We all work together as a team. Sometimes we even, how does Linda say, iron sharpens iron.
That's true. The Bible really does say that.
I know the Bible, but she also says, listen, iron sharpens iron. Okay, then we have to sort out stuff and then we go on. So it also forms your character. They also help you form your character, especially because we're busy with the stuff of God. And if we're busy with the stuff of God, sometimes stuff's come out and we need to sort out.
That's very true.
Yeah.
I want you to basically give advice to ladies which is not in the forefront, that maybe never wants to be in the forefront, but they're a vital part of the calling of God in someone else's life. Or a woman that says, but I want to be in the forefront. I want everybody to see what I'm doing, but they're not supposed to be there. I want you to from where you are, because you are a vital part in this amazing ministry in the 21st century.
Yeah.
I want you to tell a lady, a woman, the importance of you being the silent voice at the background, but loud enough to move things.
Yes.
Because not everybody should be in the front line.
No, Chantal, not everybody can be in the front line, because it's very important that you have the character to be in the front line. You need to go through that process, the process of from holiness to holiness. You need to have the character. I mean, if you speak to Linda, the process she went through to be here, it is not an easy process. So it's easy for people to say, listen, I want to be in the front line, but are you prepared to walk the road they walked?
Can you fight?
Yes, can you fight? And even for me, standing by his side, God shaped my character and he stretched my character. And I had to go through it to be where I am. So, yeah.
The other thing before we close, and this is for the people that is behind the leaders that are fighting the battles in the background. I don't even think that you're in the background anymore, because everybody's seeing you right about now. So nothing is in the background anymore. But here's the thing. the people fighting behind us as the leaders, they normally get the wave of the attack as well.
Yeah.
What would you say to people that is behind their leaders and keeping their leaders' arms in the spirit, they're keeping it up? What would you say to them, knowing that they're going to get a sword, knowing that they're going to be attacked, knowing they're going to get a stone thrown at them because of who they walk with?
Yeah, I will just say to them, stand your ground. Stand your ground, go to God, pray, and make sure you've got an intimate relationship with God. So just stand your ground. And standing behind a person, say for instance someone standing behind you, they need to protect you, they need to look after you, they need to cover you, they need to have your back. So that is very important, because unity is also very important. Because if there's not unity, because where there's unity, God commands a blessing. And if there's no unity, the enemy can come in.
I want to close this episode with a prayer. But today I want to speak to somebody, and I've spoken about purpose, I think almost every episode I touch on it. But I want to say to somebody today, and I actually just want to declare it, wherever you are, that if you are the second row fighter for this amazing vision, never lose hope. Stay focused, stay prayerful, and know God sees everything that you are doing. Don't get confused about your roles. That's very important. Don't be confused. God bless you for what you are doing. Bianca, thank you so much for visiting Step Up, and I believe it's not the last time. May God bless what you are doing in Linda's life, not just in Linda's life, but also on this platform that's going over the world, this magazine, that God is using you as a handprint on this tool. Thank you.
Thanks.
Until next time, ladies, God bless you.